Hi, in this tutorial, we are going to create hologram effects. First, create a material, then click to open the window. Next, set the material's blend mode to translucent. After creating the generated band node, hold down S on the keyboard and clicked to create a parameter node and set the name and value of the parameter node. Next, connect the parameter node to the width pin of the generated band node. Then, a line will appear in the middle of the material. Next, create an absolute world position node. Next, hold down D on the keyboard and click to create a divide node and a parameter node, and then set the name and value of the parameter node. Then, connect the generated band node and the parameter node to the divide node. After creating the component mask node, check green and blue in the component mask node and connect it with the divide node. Next, create the panner node and set the Y value of the panner node. And connect each of the nodes like the video. If you preview the generated band node, you can see the stripes going down. Next, after copying all the nodes created so far, change the name and value of the parameter node of the copied nodes. While holding down on the keyboard, click to create and add node, and then connect the generated band node to the add node. Next, while holding down 3 on the keyboard and click to create the constant 3 vector node. After that, while holding down T on the keyboard, click to create the texture sample node. Set default texture to the texture sample node. Next, after creating the panner node, set the X value of the panner node. Connect it with the texture sample node. Next, after converting the constant 3 vector node and the texture sample node to the parameter node, set the desired color to the constant 3 vector node. Next, hold down M on the keyboard and click to create the multiply node, connect it to the constant 3 vector node and the texture sample node. Then, create the blend overlay node and connect it to the multiply node and the add node. Now, the blend overlay node blends the striped and colored texture. After creating the Fresnel function node, create the parameter node and set the name and value of the parameter node. Connect it to the Fresnel function node. When you preview the Fresnel function node, the border of the material will glow brightly. Next, create the texture sample node, set the Perlin noise texture provided by start content. Next, create the text chord node and create the multiply node. Set the value of the multiply node like the video, and then connect it with the text chord node. Next, create the screen position node, create the multiply node, connect the screen position node and the multiply node to the created multiply node. After creating the panner node, set the Y value of the panner node and connect the nodes like the video. After creating a multiply node, connect the Fresnel node and the texture sample node to the created multiply node to make a ripple on the border of the material. Create a multiply node once more, create a parameter node, and set the name and value of the parameter node. Connect the parameter node and multiply node to the created multiply node. Next, create a multiply node and an add node one by one, and then connect the previously created nodes like the video to the created multiply node and add node. Lastly, after creating a parameter node, set the parameter name and value and connect it to the opacity of the material. Save and return to the content browser. Drag the desired static mesh from the place actor and place it into the level. Then, right-click on the material created so far to create an instance, and then apply the instance to the desired mesh or character. Now, click the created instance to open the window, check the parameter group, and set the parameter values.